Hey, thank you for joining us for this demo. Today we're going to take a look at how to use the Border0 connector to make it really easy to make a SSH server available, for example, one to use as a Bastion host or a jump box. So what we have here is a VM, which acts as a jump box. So just let me show you for fun how this machine sits behind NAT. It only has a private IP address. And that will come into play later as we start to demonstrate how we're going to access this. But first off, let's start with installing the connector binary. So we can go to border0.com/download, select the right OS, copy the instructions, and there we go. So this is how we install the binary. Next up, we need to install the actual server. So let's do that next. Sudo border0 connector install. So this will install the systemd unit in this case. It will ask me to log in first. I already logged in to the portal, so that went pretty quick. So what's happening under the covers, it's downloading a access token just for this connector. It's installing the service, and it also created a new SSH service for me, which I can validate by looking at the sockets that were created. So socket Bastion01 socket show. And you can see that we have this service being installed. So that's it. So that was pretty easy. Service install, systemd unit, all that kind of good stuff, right? So next up, we'd like to actually access this service. So now your teammates need access to this service as well. So how do they do that? So there's two ways to do that. So first of all, we can use the Border0 supplied tools, or you can just use OpenSSH. So let's first log in. Well, let's try to just OpenSSH into it. So SSH, Ubuntu, at the service that we just created. You can see how it immediately asked me to log in. So this is a key part of it. So first off, this machine doesn't sit on the internet. It's sitting behind NAT. And the way this works is it's having an outbound tunnel connection to the Border0 any cost infrastructure, making it highly available and fast for everyone to connect to. And that's why I don't need a VPN. Second of all, I don't have keys on this system, right? So it's just asking me for my SSO credentials. The policies allow my SSO credentials to log into this service. And now I can just log in. So this is really powerful because I was able to log in using just my single sign-on credentials and no VPN or et cetera, right? So you can also kind of see where we come from. So you can see this is a Border0 connection. So that was the first way using the SSH tooling. The other one is also interesting to show Border0 client SSH will show me all the SSH services that I have access to. So we just created this Bastion01 service. So let's take a look at that. And so now I'm in here as well, right? So that's a great way to make services available. Super easy to install, super easy to access as a client. Now let's go back to the administrator portal. So let me log in here, portal.bivery0.com. So we're changing personas. We are now again the administrator. So let's take a look at all the sessions. So one of the nice things this provides is show me exactly who's accessing this new service that we just created, from when and where. So I can see it was indeed me that logged in for as user Ubuntu from this IP to this service on this date and time. I can also see that this session is still live. So if I click terminate session, we'll see that this immediately dies. So this is all real time. Well, the nice other thing now is if this was a Bastion host, you know, I logged in as user Ubuntu. You don't normally know exactly who actually logged in, but we can see that it was indeed my SSO credential, so maybe one of your team members. And if you want to see what's going on, so not only can we see who logged in, from where, and how long, but we can also replay that session. Now, I didn't do much. I think I typed in W, and that's all we did, which is what you can see in the replay of this session. So you can see the screen size and speed, etc., are exactly the same as we did in the demo. So how do you know who has access to these services? Well, that's what is defined in policies. So using Border0, it's very easy to define flexible policies that allow you to define who should have access to this service under what circumstances. So in this case, you can see the conditions here. So anyone in border0.com, that should come from where? Well, all of these countries. So we didn't define IP addresses, but we did define a list of countries. And we actually disallowed a particular country. We can also say between this date range and this time of day, right? And so you can edit that either using our visual editor or the JSON policy editor. So that's it. In summary, we looked at how easy it was to install the connector. It took us 1 minute. We then saw how easy it was to actually access the servers using either OpenSSH CLIs, tools that you may be used to already, or using the Border0 CLI or any of the other Border0 tools. We have a desktop app as well, and that makes it really easy to discover resources. Finally, we looked at showing you all the details of each session. So not only did we know that it was user Ubuntu that logged in, but we knew it was actually Andre at border0.com. I could exactly see from where and when, and we were able to replay that. And finally, we took a look at the policy that allows us to find who has access under what circumstances. So that's it. Give it a try and let us know how it goes.